Is this the dream of the turtle?
Well, what did you get in here?
I've always been here.
See, have we been doing Zoom recordings for no reason then? Have you been here all this time?
Yeah, I've been hiding under your couch for your quarantine.
Oh, for fuck's sake, man. I've been eating there.
You almost said I've been shitting there. You don't eat where you shit.
Only once, and that was by accident.
So why are we watching this Monkey Island playthrough?
I'm trying to get a hype going for Monkey Island 3.
So you decided to show an inferior version.
Mm. I'm just saying, if we can make magic out of this. You'll be meeting the bravest Hidalgo who have hoisted the Johnny Roger. That's really not an incentive, lads, to be fair.
And the Orion.
Yes.
Why does he have, like, Aztec symbols on his ship?
Because these game creators don't know their own fucking history.
Okay. They've proven that already with the Spanish Inquisition.
Yeah.
Despite appearances, you have the upper hand on me, lad. Being that I can seal neither name nor rank.
What the
nor
fuck is with the set? Jesus.
Fucking ridiculous.
Yours indeed.
Like, what upsets me more is that, like Brian is quite literally dressed as Guyber Streepwood. Like, they're not even trying to hide it. Like, I'd be scarlet if, like, my design was, like, almost similar to someone else. Brushing bark? Like, fuck off. Brushy.
From the newest boroughs of York.
York, yeah.
With a metal hook in the fashion of a flag. Board your ship, sir. I vast there come. I merely wish to be press games and become a pirate on your Orion.
And then you should have signed up properly.
Yeah. Submit the three forms, find the three magic t-shirts of the pirates, and then steal other puzzles from the game.
Yes.
Which they do, actually, by the way.
Incidentally, you need to talk to the quartermaster, not the captain.
Yeah. Hello, are you saying that, that Pendulo got something wrong in this game?
About pirates?
Yeah.
No, no, they'd never be wrong about pirates.
No.
I mean, their masters are stealing shit that doesn't belong to them.
So tell me, lad, what about me and them English barbs?
I enjoyed that.
The monks are praying night and day, saying you're a devil fleeing from hellfire.
Right.
The ladies sigh upon hearing about
this is all completely irrelevant.
I'm just annoyed that the chess pieces are oversized so the drawers won't even close.
Yeah. Oversized so that we can see them.
Yeah.
I don't even think they're items.
Okay, why is this girl on the ship anyway?
I don't know.
Wasn't that considered a bad look?
Well, you see, this is what's happening here. Obviously, Brian is having a fucking fever dream after being bonked on the head.
Yeah, and he wants to shag another woman.
Yeah. But it's the same girl from the ship.
Mm-hmm.
But he's also hallucinated the two henchmen from the first game. Along with, like, you know, not Cooper. Wow. So literally it's a mix of the two games. Situation.
But at least I managed to board the Orion. If the Interfector's crew obeys my orders, they will besiege the Orion this very afternoon.
Right.
So I have but a few hours to remove these shackles. Find the hidden beacon of
I see, and that's where it's going to be in the moment
when you wake up, yeah.
To abscond in a dinghy, return to the
stop talking out loud, she's right here! It's not even that, it's just like, he's talking to us about what this entire level is. It's like, can you even be any more transparent? Give us a checklist.
Shut your trap, monks.
They're not even consistent with that. He is just talking to himself.
He's diegetic. He does say it out loud. People just ignore him.
And with a set of horns to rival the Cretan bull.
Oh my god.
Their technical name is katanas, if I remember right.
Brilliant. You're good. You're really good at this.
Tail from here. It's one of the latest models sold in Europe's marketplaces.
Do Kabuto helmet horns rival the Minotaur?
It doesn't. He doesn't know what he's talking about.
What the devil is she scribbling down so devoutly?
I love it, like, What I love about it is that, like, the voice actor isn't even trying to do an accent. Because, obviously, he doesn't want to, or the direction is, no, you're just Brian, being a pirate.
Save them for the sharks, Monsieur Bursion. Soon, thou shalt be kissing the keel, with need of their help more than mine.
All right.
I doubt the sharks would make a banquet of my squalid flesh, but that is not the reason for my arrival on board.
Bad writing.
Terrible writing.
And perhaps we can seek a manner to achieve safe and sound escape from the Orion together.
Very apropos, Monsieur Brachion. As to our plan?
Well...
Has there a plan? Fuck's sake.
I am not designing one. Sooner or later, I shall have one. But in the meantime, lady...
Camille. Mademoiselle Camille de la Bouille.
Ah, a Simpsons fan.
I doubt the Antunias will throw me overboard. The poor sawdust...
Can I also point out how much they use the surname Malentunes in all of their works? Because the guy, that wasn't named the fucking, the main character, John Yesterday, his surname was Valentunes. Or, sorry, the guy that he was living with, the Grandmaster, he was Valentunes as well. Like, I'm not saying they're typecasting their own surnames, but that'd be like us as Irishmen constantly calling our fucking, like, characters like O'Connor in each of one of our works. It's one of our laws. We have to have at least one O'Connor in each of our games.
O'Connor, looks like I have all the horses.
Bye. Do you know what we do is, right? When we make our own Point of the Adventure game, we're going to do Tis Piss Take of Runaway as the final level that completely has nothing to do with the rest of the plot.
We'll take a Piss Take of Runaway, but we'll accidentally end up ripping off Monkey Island somehow.
Yeah, because that's how it's going to work. In fairness, Runaway is just a piss take of every other point and click adventure that's done better.
Oh, it's a parody.
That's okay.
Captain, stop putting daggers in your table.
It's very distracting.
You'll allow me a last wish before feeding me to the sharks, I do.
And we shall it be. I'm warning thee that I wish not to be thrown to the sharks or any similar act. And that the act performed unto me must be taken on the captain, was abolished by the Tortuga Convention months ago.
Ah, Tortuga.
Well, that junk sunk my strategy. Hook, line, and sinker. This subject matter is too macabre to discuss with the ladies.
Speak for thyself.
Fuck my hell.
What are you doing on board?
Upon mooring at Tortuga Island, where right. I spent my days learning English by reading old tales.
No, that's not how you
do
okay, whatever.
No.
Malentunes held a contest to press game one lucky new deckhand, and guess who won?
What type of.
See, this is horseshit because the Malentunes guy is based off the one of the henchmen. So he's not even based off the Dean Grassett guy.
Yeah.
So, wait, what the fuck are you on about?
So he's mixing things up in his head.
Yes. And look, there's three fucking like trials as well.
Which I found in the depths of a chocolate receptacle. Damn the hour in which I spied that coin.
I've never heard of a girl deckhand.
Neither thou, nor I, nor Malentunes. Wherefore I took part in the contest in the guise of a haughty lad. I wasn't found out till we reached the high seas, and my neck was spared by dumb luck.
Brilliant.
Yeah, ask how your womanhood came to be known on board.
It's a bit late to be putting on the accent, Brian.
I shall respond in a manner concordant with
whatever. Like, I wouldn't mind if, like every character was in on the joke, in a sense, where like, they're all putting on a voice. You can't just chop and change it whenever you feel like it. That's just fundamentally wrong.
To write down his memories. So he called for a
scribe. So the fact that she was able to write.
I alone claim to know the upper.
Essentially, yeah, that's the only reason she's on board.
No, that's how they figured out she was a girl.
Oh, she was smart. She had smarts.
Malentunes touched his mustachio and yelled to his men. Lady Luck has smiled down on us. Ye, I see his half-breeds. Do with her as you wish. The crew assembled around me with blood filling their eyes. Well, their eyes and other organs. So, at the last moment, I whipped out a dagger from my boot and...
A bone-chilling tale of pseudo-biblical proportions.
Yeah. Let her finish, maybe.
Pirates were very religious. They'd never do that.
No.
How you managed to change your fate. For I see you moisten the quill and scribble in that book like a true scribe.
The problem...
And again, it's not the captain that gives the orders.
No.
He only has order-giving powers when they're in battle.
The one whereby drunkards are wont to write their names. Thou must know, it involves great imbibing of grog, and when the gladiator's death scene is imminent, removing one's codpiece, aiming and...
Speak no further, milady.
I honestly think they must think that this all is hilarious.
Overriding is funny.
And it's just like, it's... There's so much redundant, like, words in this game that is just like, I'm not even paying attention to half of it anymore. The watcher tells me, exercise all dialogue with the character, I will, because I don't know how shit the programming of this game is. Considering one level was actually clogged up because of snow.
Yes.
I don't have much standards, to be honest.
And the New World courts abound with fables of Melandunia's duel with the devil.
Can I think of that?
Who are you talking about, us or Brian?
Jesus, if we're dead, then we're definitely in hell.
Melantunius challenged the devil.
That's our penance for putting out terrible YouTube content to keep watching the worst games possible.
We can't go to hell. You can't be sent there twice.
Exactly. This is hell. Let's be fair, out of all the games that we have riffed on, I feel like this is the worst one. I don't know why. This just feels worse.
It's definitely the longest.
Yeah. I think because, it's like 9 hours of chaff. Like, the story is like 3 hours long, but there's like 6 hours of redundant dialogue. It's like a fucking video game version of the Da Vinci Code.
Once the captain mounted the brilliant talisman in the boat's figurehead, I'm not the superstitious type. But it's true that the beacon will some power beyond...
Great, so now we're actually getting to the point of this level.
What
super.
Is the beacon
we saying? Already know, Brian.
Yes, but...
We're aware of the aliens.
Yeah, but Brushing fucking Beakwood doesn't fucking know this. He's too busy fighting ghost pirates and, you know, dodging used ship salesmen. After listening to him, by the way, if you're watching this at home, I'm sorry. We did not design this game. Blame them.
Oh, good God. Springtime for Hitler in Germany.
As for the remaining Melatonian lore.
No, please, no.
You have to read it all, don't you?
I have to read it all.
Yes, but not much. Because
it is that kind of thing where, like, if you don't trigger any other dialogue points, the game stalls halfway through. Because, like, again, you might know the solution of the puzzle, but because your character doesn't know, you won't be able to do it. And then you have to talk about it first and then do it.
Now the 12 are now for there for the krakens and tritons on the sea floor, while our vessel's sole injury was that of a novice blunderbuss shooter who suffered a self-inflicted wound.
Okay.
Leave the superstitions to the dim Spaniards and talk facts.
True, 'tis that dim wittiness has found Spanish soil to be fertile, but no more than in your native England or my beloved France.
We'll carry on later, Lady Camille.
As thou wishest, Monsieur Grachon.
Because Brushing is such a English-British name, you know?
Yeah,
any respectable pirate prefers Russian roulette or a good spinning contest.
What?
Yeah, spinning contest from Monkey Island 2.
No, I mean, what's Russian?
Give or take a fact.
Good point. Actually, yeah, good point. They won't know what Russian is.
Not very sharp.
God damn it.
No,
people are so shit at everything.
And my physicians have forbidden me from using all blades.
Fucking hell.
Well, considering its blade is short and dull, and that someone left it behind on the right...
Pick up the fucking blade.
Regarded as a mere...
God, waxing lyrical and fucking work.
My God.
It's a fine letter opener in the shape of a dagger.
It's just so ridiculous. It's like... This game, that is always the guilty of this game, is literally having an agonizing over picking up items. There are other characters who literally will pick up everything, and that's it.
What is it?
It's an ink. It was a paperweight.
The mechanism is simple. Two iron crescents linked by a moving hinge at one side.
Call them manacle, you dickhead.
The other side is a bolt into which Husky Hound has pounded a nail to keep the shackles from opening.
It's called a manacle.
The bad part is that it's jammed so far in that it's stuck.
It's a manacle. Just say manacle.
It's a manacle.
If the tip were thinner, maybe I could. It's too wide, though.
That's what she said.
Nah.
No, the shackles are too well made for such a thing to work.
Okay.
So you give me two items, and both of them are useless.
It looks like it was put there to wound any and all passersby. Yes, the crosses on the handle of the dagger, I mean the letter opener, are curved.
For fuck's sake.
So perhaps I can use them to pull out the nail. A shame I can't reach it, because it would really be conducive to my escape.
Right.
Great.
Hark, Lady Camille, I doth throw a letter opener towards thee in the form of a dagger.
What do I owe this honor, monsieur?
Allow me to request that you use the curved handle of the letter opener to release the nail sprouting from the beam behind thee, and then to be so kind as to toss the metal spike towards me straight away.
Okay.
One can only hope it'll land in your eye.
But I shall appease thee. Hand me that letter opener.
Take care not to cause a scandal, or the pirate at the door may hear us.
Get down from there, you hornswoggler.
I get a feeling that was just perfectly timed.
Yeah. No, look there. Look.
Chance means maybe.
Can you?
I think it's coming out.
So, demon dog, are you gonna let me in someday? No. Holy.
Where did it fall?
Next to thy leg.
Okay.
Wait. Are you sure? Yes. Dead.
Stupid cabinet.
What's that, huh?
Yes, my head. Ow.
Ow? What does ow mean? We never discuss anything about ow.
Bloody nail. Ouch! I appear to have pricked my unmentionables, but it was worthwhile, because now the nail is mine.
I avail that thou art an easy man to make up in, monsieur.
So there was no reason for him to put that in the treasures.
No reason at all.
Because
again, we're too thick now to realize that's the one item we need for this puzzle, because we can't reach anything else at this level.
The nail is thin enough to press down the bolt, and I can strike it with the letter opener like a mallet. Let's hope the pirate at the door doesn't hear.
Well, metal on metal never makes a sound.
Sharp blow means gates. Chain noise.
I thought you said he was going to strike with the letter opener.
Nope.
Ow means with great pleasure. Okay. Okay. That means yes.
I don't get this bit.
It's not funny. Is it because this guy's a skeleton?
Well,
and, like, he's trying to talk to him with, like, the sound of chains.
Ah. It's nice to know we can do some trading together. With great pleasure, eh?
By Jove, I smashed my ankle.
I'm really quite pleased about your change in attitude. You wouldn't be lying to me now, would ya?
Free at last.
The chains were... Huh? What do you mean, of course?
Make haste, then, and set me free as well.
You think you can mock me and get away scot-free?
What?
You bloody son of a shit.
I don't get it.
It's not funny, man. It's just not.
And rip your heart out when you exit. You hear me?
As I told you, my duty is to find...
How fucking terrible is this?
Return to the Interfector and sink the Orion.
I am indebted to thee, so I shall help thee. I know that...
That's not your duty, though.
No,
you just want the ship to sink.
Yes.
I shall find...